Hello everyone, I'm Greatlook, thank you for joining me, and welcome back to Factorio or Bob's Mods episode 48. Let's work towards better modules still. At some point we do need all the way up to level 8. And by then I guess, well, I haven't decided if we are going to use raw modules yet. Raw productivity modules gives us 40% increased productivity and nothing else. Which seems a bit much maybe. But honestly, I think we should just work towards it. Sorry. So, if we do that, we should probably just start doing it now instead of focusing on normal blues and normal reds, or normal speed and normal productivity. Get raw speed and raw productivity instead. Honestly, I think we should do that, but we need some research for that, of course. So let's research effect combining, and we'll just let these run. This is still somewhat useful, I guess. Meanwhile, we can think about getting iron ore, or ferric chloride, I guess we decided that we wanted to train in instead. So we should probably use this patch for ferric chloride. Lots of stone up here apparently. Let's work on that. You won't need a lot of mining drills for that. Not yet at least. And it just needs some hydrogen chloride, which is made in chemical plants. From this, so chemical plants, electrolyzers, and what makes the salt? Chemical furnace. Okay, chemical furnace, electrolyzer, and chemical labs. Lots of chemical furnaces. Okay, let's just fill up on electrolyzers as well. How many chemical labs do we have? None as far as I can see. Let's get 50 flows. Should we, while we're here, upgrade to personal Robo Quartz Mark IIs? Well, we might as well, right? So three of those, take 300 blue circuits, which are down here, and a lot of personal RoboPorts. So we need batteries and stuff for those. Is that all the batteries we got? I guess so. No, it's not. We have 400 somewhere. There we go. And there we go. Okay. Need one more red circuit. Let's start with that and let's go. Should we take the train? I guess we should, for now at least. Just bring this with us. That should be enough. let's just park out here for now. Just having a look at how much this radius expands. Get it done, please. An okay amount. Okay, so we need some iron, and we need some chemical stuff. The iron is easy, so let's start with that. Let's just go all the way. There we go. And of course this, the production of the chlorine, hydrogen chloride is called, also will produce some sodium hydroxide as per usual, so we'll just have to make room to actually export that. Yeah. So, can we steal this setup from somewhere else? That is actually using the... Well, something like this, I guess. Let's just do it manually. I need to get used to it anyway. We will probably need this quite a lot. So... chemical furnaces that make salt. And we need a pump to give us the water. And we might as well start crafting some pipe, because we're going to need a lot of it. So this will output salt. And as far as I remember, these were pretty fast. One salt every half a second, times two. So four salt a second. That does require some optimized inserters. Could just have copied these, but who cares? And of course, we should balance. There we go. And then we need... is it electrolyzers now? Electrolyzers, yes. And we need these with a space in between because of the outputs. And actually, this should go directly into this, right? That was the same ratio. Yeah, it is. So there's no reason to put them apart. At least not if they have a good crafting time. 2 seconds to reduce 25. 1 second to use half of that. That should make sense. 1.5 crafting speed compared to 1 crafting speed. That is a bit worse, of course. But it just means these will be filled. Let's just do it. So, inputs. Input. Now, this won't be enough to both input and output, so that is one reason why we wouldn't want this, but if we just this does give us enough space, but it's not as pretty as we will have the outputs like that. Should we just put another space in between them? Or should we put space in between these so that we can build, have a built in there? I'm not sure, to be honest, but let's do this for now. Pure water, please. Oh, yeah. Wait, that's wrong. There. Let's bring some power out here so we can just have a look at what we need and what we don't. And of course, we're out of big power poles. Steal some from here for now. Why are my module effects not? Oh, we need one of those, right? We're only producing these three, and we need the dark green ones. So let's research something else meanwhile until I get back there. Bigger inventory is always nice. And we need to set the recipes for these, of course. And of course, we need outputs for these as well. I just want to see this one move again, because it did seem a bit slow before. But I guess that's okay. So we have hydrogen chloride now, which should be all we need for ferric chloride, right? Yeah. Great. So, in chemical labs, we produce this stuff. Well, let's just keep a space in between every two of these. And of course, at some point we need an input for this. Let's just get that now. Probably put a tank down for this as well. Let's just do that here. Actually, let's put it in line instead. So everything has to go through this. And this should produce our ferric chloride. And I guess we'll just bottle that up, or barrel it up, or whatever you do with ferric chloride. Well, canister it up then. I really wish you could just get off with only one type of barreling system, but oh well. Let's go get some canisters and let's research some more. Maybe I actually needed those. Oh well. So I did produce canisters here. Maybe we even have some in store. No, we do not. These cannot keep up at all, that's just nice. So we'll just improve them, I guess. There we go. Lots and lots of canisters. Let's just go use those, unless I should put down the dark green one of these. I guess I should. And we need one of these whiteboard makers for that. It's not that these aren't backed up now, but if everything starts running, then we shouldn't have enough otherwise. So we should be able to research our effect combining now. Oh, I guess it was pumps that put this into canisters. And we'll just quest empty canisters. Will these inserters be able to keep up? Apparently not. So let's switch it out so that we do it like that and like this. I guess we shouldn't really limit this. And that keeps up with these two at least. How much can be in a canister? Is it the same as with barrels or is it less or more? Is that not possible to see? Not from that, but maybe from the recipe. You get 50. That is the same as with barrels, right? Yep. Okie dokie. Is my... Oh, I haven't put this in yet. Interesting. Should make things a bit easier to see while flying around, so that's nice. Let's research this effect combining stuff. It's a bit weird that I want to build all the normal resources around, but now I want to robot my fluids around. Maybe I should just put these on a belt as well. But we will need a station for the ferric chloride and we need one for the sodium hydroxide. We'll just put down those stations around here. That's ferric chloride, and well, actually, we have a proper blueprint for this, I guess. We shouldn't. I decided to use fluid wagons, right? Yeah, so let's be a bit more consistent about that. So we will have to decanister all this ferric chloride over here. Or maybe we should keep this for sodium hydroxide and then we'll make this in here. Let's do that. And then we will need robots to carry out around the canisters, but that's okay. 8 of those. We do need more pumps, so probably have to go back for those. I don't have any engines on me. So let's put down a balancer for the sodium hydroxide. This should probably have been a part of the blueprint, but I'm not gonna worry about that right now. Oh yeah, these only go a short distance. Just make a bit of room for more hydrogen chloride. What's it called? Yeah, hydrogen chloride. We will probably have to increase this production at some point. So these take, what, 30 every 2.5 seconds. And these produce 25 every 2 seconds. So we should be able to double this and still be heavy. Do I have any RoboPods with me? I apparently do not. So RoboPods and pumps are my main concerns. Module effect transmission has completed. RoboPorts and some engines for pumps and some other good stuff like iron gear wheels or more personal RoboPorts. Let's just request some low density structure again. 2, 3 engines. Let's just make all the pumps. I guess I can spare that one room for those. Raw productivity modules, go. I guess that's all we need right now. So let's go back. If anyone's wondering why I'm making those circles, it's just because you can't brake fast enough. So unless you just want to shoot past it, you just need to stay in the area, I guess. And why did I make... No, sorry, it just doesn't have any power. That's nice. It isn't, but you know what I mean. It's easy to fix. These should unload my ferric chloride. And we should put some robots... Oh, I'm pretty sure I forgot all about getting robots with me. We do not have any logistic robots. Let's go and grab some. I'm not gonna put all of those into the ferric chloride production, but it's nice to have some on me at all times. So how about 50 of those? But unfortunately, that's all we got time for in this episode, so thank you all for joining me, and I'll see you next time. Bye.